Red Gobbo is a much-loved classic character from Gorka Morka. He's here to steal Christmas, your heart, and anything else he can get his grubby mitts on. In this video, we're going to show how to paint this much-loved character, so grab those brushes, shake those paints, and let's get started. Before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey. Now, I know what you're thinking, it's not red, but that's okay. It will slow your painting down ever so slightly, but grey is perfect for all the colours we're going to be applying in this video. Now, the first area we're going to concentrate on is the skin, and we're going to start with Deathwood Forest. So I'm going to give the pot a quick shake, and we're ready to begin painting. Now, because it's a skin, they're kind of small areas, I'm just going to start by using a small layer brush. So all I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the corner like so. Add a little touch of water as well, not too much. We just don't want it to be too thick and goopy. So once we've loaded the brush up, give it a couple of spins to get a nice point like so. And then we're ready to start base coating. Now there's a couple of areas to focus on. You've got his face, you've got his hands, you've got his legs, and he's got a little bit of belly sticking out as well. So just keep going until you get a nice smooth finish, and all you need to do is apply a couple of thin coats. There we are with the skin now base coated. We're going to move on to the next step, which is to apply a shade. Now for this, we're going to be using Beale Tan Green. This is just to add some definition to that skin detail. So I'm going to be moving on to a medium layer brush for this. So what I'm going to do is apply a little bit to the palette. Now you can use it straight from the pot, but I'm just going to apply it to the palette just so I don't overload the brush too much and get a nice point to those bristles as well. So just give it a couple of rolls like so, get a nice point, and then we're ready to start applying it. Now at this point, when you're painting the model, don't worry if you get paint elsewhere because you will paint it over those details, especially on the grey details, like round here and stuff. So don't be too precious about it because you'll paint over it anyway. So just take your time and just let that paint run into the recesses. If you do find it pooling, just use your brush to soak up any excess. With the shade now dry, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to apply a layer. Now this is just going to pick out those raised details on the skin, and for this we'll be using Elysian Green. So I'm going to move back to my small layer brush. I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette like so. Add a tiny touch of water. We don't need too much of this because it is a layer paint, slightly less pigment in it. So make sure we get our brush just to a nice point and then we're ready. Now the idea of what you're doing here is you're trying to pick out those raised details. So if we start with the leg first, you still want to keep those bits of Beale Tan Green in the recesses, but still trying to maintain like a bit of definition. So all you're doing is just trying to pick out the raised details like so. If you go to the face, like doing the nose, picking out those nostrils, again, just maintaining some of that Beale Tan Green in the recesses. There we are with the skin now layered. We're gonna move on to the next step, which is to do some highlighting. Now we're gonna be using two colors, one after the other. We're gonna start with Ogryn Camo, and after that, we'll move on to Kislev Flesh. But first of all, let's start with the Ogryn Camo. So all I'm gonna do is apply a little bit to the palette again, a little touch of water, not too much. Want to make it too runny, get our brush to a nice point, and then we're ready to start highlighting. Now the idea here is just to pick out those extremities, so like things like the nose, you're just doing a nice fine highlight like so, just on the nose, picking out things like his nostrils, just do this all the way across the model, like the ears, the lips, knuckles, fingers, etc. With that first highlight now completed, we're going to finish off by using Kislev Flesh, and what we're doing here is just picking out those real extreme extremities, like the nose, the lips, and the knuckles. Now by using like a normal flesh tone like Kislev Flesh, this just adds a little bit more warmth to what is a very green skin tone. There we are with the green skin now completed. We're going to move on to the next area, which is to paint the white details. Now for this we'll be using Korax White. We're going to be picking areas out like the fur on his cloak, the snow on the base, the white on his gun casing and his beard. Now I'm going to be using a medium layer brush for this, so I'm going to slightly larger again. So what I'm going to do is apply a little bit to the palette like so. Now I am going to thin this down a little bit more than I normally would. This is mainly just for the cloak or the fur on the cloak, just so it sinks into those details a bit more. But things like the beard and the snow base, you can just use straight from the pot. So once I've added enough water, we're ready to start applying it. So as you can see, like there's a lot of texture actually on the fur here. So what I'm going to do is just start running my brush in there, and I might have to do a couple of thin coats, but it does mean it gets nicely covered. So just do all the fur first and then move on to the other areas after. There we are with all those white details now base coated. You'll also notice I've just picked out the star on his stick as well. So what I'm going to do now is going to move on to applying a contrast paint. For this we'll be using Apothecary White. Now we're just going to keep this to the fur, the beard and his gun casing. So what I'm going to do is continue using my medium layer brush. I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette again, just not to overload my brush too much. Then I'm going to start getting ready to apply that to the fur. So what I'm going to do is just start applying it on like so. You probably have to do a couple of spoonfuls, or brushfuls if you like. Now when you get to things like the medal, just avoid trying to get onto this star here. If you do get it on it, just wait until it's dry and then just reapply Korax White, because we'll be needing that for later on in the video. There we are with the apothecary white now dry. What we're going to do now is we're going to move on to a highlight. For this, we'll be doing a dry brush and we'll be using Ulthuan Grey for this. So I'm just going to grab a small dry brush. I'm going to apply a little bit to the brush like so. And then the key thing here is just to wipe off as much as possible. Now you're aiming to get as much off the actual bristles as you can, but pigments will still maintain on those bristles. So once you've got what you think is the most of it off, we're ready to start dry brushing. So what I'm going to do now is just start actually just working actually on the fur. So I'm just going to go back and forth like so. And as you can see, it will start to pick out those details of fur. Now, because it's quite early on in the process of painting the model, the great thing here is we can be a little bit more rougher and a little bit, well, less neat. However, as you get closer to the green skin, that's where you want to be most careful. So just maintain most of the dry brushing where there's areas that haven't been painted yet, picking out those highlights, and then just as you move around, just be very careful not to get on the green. And if you do, just tidy back up with the colours you've highlighted with. There we are with that dry brush now done. We're going to move on to the next step, which is to do another dry brush, but this is with White Scar. So again, it's the same process as before. So all we're going to do is get a little bit on the bristles, wipe off as much as we possibly can. And then once we're happy, we're then ready to start doing some dry brushing. Now, the key thing here is just to do the extremities, so we're not going to go mad. And also, we need to go a bit lighter as well, so you're almost tickling the model. So I'm just going to do the corners of the fur here like so, just to get some of those edges like picked out, and then just like the tip of the beard as well. So just work your way around again like you did before, just picking out those extremities. There we are with the white done. We're now going to move on to picking out the red details. Now for this, we're going to be using Mephiston Red to start off with as a base coat. We're then going to follow that with Flesh Terror Red. We're going to apply that all over. We're also going to use it to make the candy cane design on the gun and the medal as well. Following that, we're then going to highlight using Evil Sun Scarlet, and then we'll finish off with a final highlight of Wild Rider Red. But first of all, let's start with that Mephiston Red. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette again. Again, just a couple of dollops, dollop of water, so it's not too thick and goopy. And again, the key thing is to get a nice point to your brush. And we're ready to start picking out that red jacket. So again, you might want to do a couple of thin coats, but just slowly work your way around the model. One of the things I'd probably recommend doing is, especially around his coat, is if you can see he's got a little bit of trim there. So all you need to do is just get a little bit more on your brush like so. And probably just work all the way around the trim, just taking your time. This will give you a nice sort of line to work to. Then you can just fill in after. There we are with the Mephiston Red now base coated. We're going to move on to applying Flesh Terror Red. Now I'm going to start by doing the candy cane design on the gun and the medal. So what I'm going to do is just start off at an angle, just doing like a little red stripe like so. Now, if you do make any mistakes at this point, don't worry, just use Corax White and tidy back up. But what I would recommend doing is using another brush to do that, because you don't want to make it pink, because that can be the downside sometimes. If you don't wash your brush thoroughly enough, it will go a bit pink. Now, as you can see, it can be quite wibbly wobbly, so that will happen, but don't worry. So just do that on both the medal and the gun. And once you've done that, just apply Flesh Terror Red straight from the pot all over the cloak. There we are with the Flesh Terror Red now applied and dry. You'll also notice I just did the grenade in his pocket in the same design as well. So what I'm going to do now is start using the Evil Sun Scarlet as a highlight. So I'm going to do a broad highlight, so it's quite thick. I'm just going to work along all the edges of the cloak as well when we're doing this. Just take your time. If you make any mistakes, just use some Mephiston Red and reapply some Flesh Terror's Red just to make it tie in nicely. There we are with those areas now highlighted with Evil Sun Scarlet. We're going to finish off with a fine highlight of Wild Rider Red. Now we're just going to keep this to some of the extremities, so just where the light's going to be touching. So you don't have to do the whole thing, just like corners, especially like when you get to the pocket and stuff like that, just like anywhere that looks like a seam. Just take your time, just pick out some of those raised areas. If you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Evil Sun Scarlet. There we are, the red now completed. We're going to move on to painting the next detail, which is the black detail. So this is things like the leather and his boots. Now we're going to start by using a base coat of Abaddon Black. We're then going to highlight with Thunderhawk Blue and then finish off with a fine highlight of Fenrisian Grey. So first of all, let's start with that Abaddon Black. So all I'm going to do is just get a dollop onto me, pan it like so, a little bit of water. Just make sure it's not too thick and goopy. Get a nice point to the brush and then we're ready to start. Now there's only a couple of details, like I said, to think about. So you've got his boots, his belt, and there's also like a little bandolier as well on his strap by his chest. So just fill those in. You might want to do a couple of thin coats as well. With that base coat now applied, we're going to move on to the first highlight. For this, we'll be using Thunderhawk Blue. So what I'm going to be doing is doing a chunky highlight to start off with. This is just getting the setup ready for the next highlight, which will be a lot thinner. Now, if you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with a little bit of Abaddon Black. There we are with that first highlight now done. We're going to finish off with a final highlight of Fenrisian Grey. Now all we need to do here is just make sure this is a little bit thinner than the first highlight, so you can see the other one showing through slightly on either side. This will just give it a nice gradient effect. And there we are with the black now done. What we're going to do now is move on to the next section, which is to paint the wood. And for this one, we start with Catacham Flesh. We're then going to use Gnawgnaw as a shade. We're then going to highlight up using Gorthor Brown. And in some places, mainly the wood on the stick, we'll be using Baneblade Brown. So what we're going to do is we're just going to start getting a little bit of Catacham Flesh onto our palette like so. So a little touch of water. I'm ready to start loading it up and ready to begin painting. So I'll start with the ammo crate at the bottom. So you've got this ammo crate to do here. So I'm just going to base coat that like so. Make sure that's all covered. You've also got his little stick to do just here. And then just holding his beard, he's got a little bit of elastic, so paint that as well. There we are with that base coat now done. What we're going to do now is apply some Gnawn oil all over that brown. Now when you're doing this, just make sure you don't overload your brush too much because it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Now the Gnawn oil now dry, we're going to be using Gorthor Brown as a highlight. So what I'm going to do here is just start running the edge along the ammo crate like so. You need to highlight up the wooden stick, and also if you want to, just highlight that little bit of elastic around his beard. There we are, with that first highlight done, we're now going to finish off by using Baneblade Brown. Now I'm just going to keep this to the wooden box and also to his little wooden stick. There we are with those brown details now highlighted. We're going to move on to the next step, which is to paint the drab green area. So this is the ammo crate and the foliage on his stick. Now for this we'll be using Castellan Green. We're going to shade it with Gnawn Oil and we're going to finish off with a highlight of Strachan Green. So first of all, let's start with that base paint. So what I'm going to do is apply a little bit to the palette again, like so. A little dab of water. Nice and smooth. Get a nice point and then we're ready to start. So what I'm going to do here is just start on the actual little ammo crate at the bottom and completely paint it. There are some metal details here and there, but we'll do that later on. Don't forget that you've got two little bits of foliage to do as well. There we are, the Castellan Green now applied and dry. We're just going to run some Gnawn Oil over those details. Again, just be mindful not to overload your brush too much. With that Gnawn Oil shade now dry, we're going to just start highlighting with Strachan Green. So all we're doing is picking out the edges on the ammo box and on the foliage on his stick as well. There we are with those drab green areas now done. We're going to move on to the next area, which is paint the parchment, the sack and his teeth. And for this we'll be using Rakar Flesh. Then I'm going to apply Agaros Dunes all over and finish off with a highlight of Screaming Skull. But first of all, let's start with that base coat. So as always, just apply a little bit to the palette, thin it down and then just get your brush to a nice point. So I'll start with the sack first. And all we're going to do is just do probably a couple of thin coats of this. So just apply it all over. If you need to, apply a second coat. You've also got the loincloth, which is his bit of parchment and his teeth to do. There we are with the Rakar Flesh now base coated. We're going to use Agaros Dunes and we're going to apply that over all those areas. Now when it comes to the sack, you'll notice I have actually base coated the grenades with Rakar Flesh. I'm not going to coat them in Agaros Dunes because I'll be using that later on with some Black Templar. With that contrast paint now dry, we're going to start highlighting, and for this we'll be using Screaming Skull. So for most parts we're just going to be running it around the edges and picking out those raised details. Now make sure when you do the teeth just to be a little bit sharper and a little bit finer. And if you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up and then reapply your highlights after. There we are with the sack now highlighted. What we're going to do now is move on to finish off some little details using Black Templar. This is things like the grenades in the sack, a fuse on his grenade that's just hanging out of his pocket, and also a little bit of twine on his stick as well. So what I'm going to do is just get a little bit of Black Templar, apply it to my palette, get my brush to a nice point, and then we're ready. Now for the actual grenades in the sack, you can just pour it in because we'll end up highlighting those little pins and stuff with a little bit of silver. But things like the fuse on here, and also you've got the twine up here, you just want to make sure you've got your brush to a nice point when you do that. Also at this point, if you're feeling brave, you can use the Black Templar to write some script on his little loincloth, like a little Christmas list. There we are with those black details now done. We're going to move on to the next step, which is to paint the silver areas. Now for this, we're going to start with Ironhand Steel. We're then going to shade with Gnawn Oil, then finish off with a highlight here and there of Stormhost Silver. So first of all, let's start applying the Ironhand Steel to our palette like so, and also a little bit of touch of water. Once that's ready, we're ready to start. So a couple of things you're going to be looking at doing here. You've got the working parts on the gun. You've got these clasps here on the crate. You've also got the lock as well on that crate there as well. And don't forget the pins in the grenades. With those silver areas now base coated, we're going to shade them using Gnawn Oil. So just take your time, and if you do find it overflowing, just use your brush to soak up any excess. With the shade now dry, we're going to start highlighting using Stormhost Silver. Again, in some places, just use the edge of the brush like so. But some of the places, like the gun here, you might just have to use the tip. So make sure you get a nice fine point. Now that we've highlighted all the silver areas, we're going to move on to painting the yellow details, which is all these stars. Now we're going to start by using ironed and yellow, and then we're going to highlight up using white scar. But first of all, let's start with that ironed and yellow. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette, just so I don't overload the brush too much, like so. Then get a nice point to the brush, and then we're ready to start. Now before this point, it might be worth just checking the model and make sure you just tidy back up with any Corax white in case you splodged any paint on. That being said, let's just start applying that ironed and yellow on. With that yellow now dry, we're going to start highlighting with white. So what we're going to do is start running white around the edges like so, and also in the centre. Now the great thing with this is the white will start to show some of that yellow through, so it'll look like a real pale yellow. Now that the yellow stars are done, we're going to finish off by painting all the baubles and lenses. Now before we do this, we need to get the areas base coated, and for this we're going to use Stormhost Silver. So what I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to my palette like so, so get some out of the pot, just apply a little bit to the palette. Don't overload the brush too much, and then we're ready to start base coating those bauble areas. So you've got one on his base just here, so I'm going to start doing that. One on his ear, and there's one just dangling down from his little stick as well. There we are, with those baubles and lenses now base coated with Stormhost Silver, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to apply some gem paints. Now we're going to start by using Soulstone Blue. This is going to be for the lenses on his goggles, but also I'm going to thin it down and use it on the snow. It gives it a nice, crisp, snowy effect. After that, we're going to paint two of the baubles with Spirit Stone Red and one of the baubles using Waystone Green. But first of all, let's start with Soulstone Blue. So what I'm going to do is apply a paintbrush there, like so, and then a paintbrush of water. Actually, I might add a second paintbrush of water to make it a bit thinner. So what I'm going to do is then just load my brush up, and then we're going to start painting this onto the snow. Now, when it comes to the lenses, just use it straight from the pot. You don't need to thin it down. With the lenses and snow now covered in Soulstone Blue, we're going to use Spirit Stone Red for two of the baubles. So I'm just going to do the one on the top here and the one just at the front there on the base. With the red baubles done, all we're going to do now is finish the model off by painting the bauble by his ear Waystone Green. Once that's done, all you need to do is rim the base, and I'm going to rim this in black. And there we are with the rim of the base painted, and mischievous candy cane shooter grenade wielding Red Gobbo is finished. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, it's a lot easier to start with the skin first, then do the things like the white fur and then the red after, and all the other details will fall into place. And also when using contrast paints and shades, try not to overload your brushes, it can quickly run out of control. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video, hope you enjoy painting your own Red Gobbo, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye. Oh, and Merry Christmas.